want to go ahead and bring in Avi Loeb, who is a theoretical astrophysicist and science professor at Harvard University, and joins us now live. Professor Loeb, welcome back. Good to see you. So we just finished listening to our reporter right there who was at that hearing. What have you learned so far from today's testimony? Did anything jump out at you? Did anything surprise you at all?
Well, thanks for having me. One thing that came out was the contacts that David Grush has that he's willing to share with representatives. And in fact, I wouldn't be surprised if he already shared it with them in the hour or two that elapsed since the hearing ended. And of course, he has also knowledge of the location and the people involved in this program that he refers to of retrieval, reverse engineering of alien spacecraft from crash sites. And it would be very interesting to see what it leads to in terms of information being revealed to the public. Because if there is indeed any such materials or information about alien spacecraft, it should be shared with scientists. This is not a matter of national security because we're dealing with an object that traveled thousands of light years and presumably knows nothing about national borders. So why should the US government consider it as a national security issue that should be protected from the public? I think that the next step obviously would be that scientists will get engaged in figuring out what it means.
I think there are so many questions, you know, that I could ask you right here, but I want to go ahead and focus for a second on former intelligence official David Grush, who, as you were saying, was testifying at today's hearing, saying that he does believe that there is an active disinformation campaign by the U.S. government that is taking place right now to cover up extraterrestrial life. Professor Loeb, do you agree with this assertion? I mean, why would the government want to hide this kind of information, not just from the public, but from scientists? Why isn't NASA studying this right now?
I simply do not understand that. This makes no sense for me. So there are two possible explanations. One, that they don't have anything, that it's all fabricated, because we haven't seen the direct evidence. He's talking about what he heard from a variety of people, what he saw in some written documents, but that doesn't prove that there is something behind it. That's one possibility. The second is that everything he says is correct because we hear it from different directions. Chris Mellon confirmed what he said. Other people, he said that he spoke with 40 witnesses who told him the same story. So if it's real, you know, it's just completely inappropriate on behalf of the government to hide it from the public, because if we have neighbors, we better know about it. We need to adapt to that reality, especially if there are functional devices in our neighborhood. This should not be information that is the privy of the President of the United States. It should be shared by all humans because we are dealing with science here. And they better consult with scientists that can figure out what it means. I don't think the government is a scientific organization. It's basically has a day job of taking care of national security, maintaining to the safety of military personnel and you know, citizens of the country, but they are not qualified to figure out what it means for interstellar space. And that is the role of astronomers like myself. So I'm happy to help them figure it out. It's just that they've never released that information. And that would be really, I think it's in principle also illegal because we're dealing with science here.
I think one of the reasons why there hasn't been as much transparency, and at least this was brought up today by the witnesses, is they were saying that right now there is a stigma attached to it. So number one, how do you get around that stigma? And number two, what has your own research taught you? I know that you recently recovered objects that you believe are extraterrestrial. What are you finding?
Right, so the sky is not classified. The oceans are not classified. We are free to explore them. And the government has a day job of maintaining national security. And so they monitor the sky all the time. And they could find things that we are not aware of because astronomers are looking very far away. They're not looking nearby. So it's possible the government would be the first to notice something. But You know, we should be able to find that information independent of the government. So actually, there was a meteor that came from interstellar space about a decade ago. We identified it. We decided to go after the materials. It came from interstellar space, from outside the solar system, and it was moving very fast, faster than 95% of the stars in the vicinity of the sun. It was tougher than all the space rocks. We went there to the Pacific Ocean last month, mm-hmm. and we retrieved the materials. So we are now studying those materials to tell us whether they are technological in origin. And I think the more scientists engage in that kind of inquiry, the more we will press the government to release anything they know.
All right, still so many questions. Professor Avi Loeb, thank you so much for your time and your insight. Please come back.